racing in Portugal. A really good start from Remy. A lightning start. Not so good from Sam Lowes. Almost makes contact with Remy. As we go down into turn one, Remy Gardner will it be? Or Benzecchi takes the lead. Oh, Lowes is high-sided out. Sam Lowes, the world championship leader, has high-sided out at turn one. And he's been whacked by his bike as well.
He's trapped underneath the bike as well. Lowes goes high at turn one in the worst possible way. He fluffed the start and then he was a little bit wide. Thankfully, he's back on his feet. But a monster, monster high side for Sam Lowes.
Oh, who's gone? Oh, goodness me, what's happened here? We may well see a red flag here, unless they can get that cleared up. What's gone on? I think Beaubier's gone a bit down a few paces. It's Chartra and Aguirre. Is it the teammates that have come together?
Looks like there's been a fire down there, doesn't it? Montella has crashed out.
Montella was one of the bikes, but also I've just noticed that the two Idemitsu Honda Team Asia riders have gone.
There's
Aguirre and there's Chantra.
What has happened there? Aguirre was ninth, Chantra was 10th. But now then, what's happened here? A bit further down the field, Manzi and Montella.
Oh, it's a massive high side at 15.
Nothing Manzi could do about that.
And that's a fireball.
Yari Montella got hit, didn't he, by massive high side for him. Stefano Manzi just had nowhere to go. He's got lightning quick reaction time as Manzi, but just nothing he could do to take evasive action. Fireball smash.
It's not friendly fire, is it? Oh, a clatter there. That's a racing incident, and unfortunately, Chantra knew nothing about it. Contact between Aguirre and Beaubier, and going downhill into turn five, which is awkward as it is. Benzecchi, though,
he's
doing a fantastic job.
He is clearing off, isn't he, Benzecchi? Over 1.1 seconds clear now, with Roberts in second place. And while Roberts, Gardner, Canet, and Fernandez engage yet again, this is all that Benzecchi needs.
Canet looks like he's got the speed to get through and maybe chase down Benzecchi, whose lead has shrunk by another 10th.
On the last lap, Steve, Canet was by far the quickest man on circuit
to you, but I think Benzecchi has a moment there, and they're with him as Canet now goes through. I just don't think Remy Gardner was expecting that the fight was going to come from all of these guys.
He's regrouped.
Another twitch from the rear end there. And that has allowed Canet through. Benzecchi then hitting rear tyre trouble, I think.
Uncharacteristic mistake there.
Contact there.
Big contact between Fernandez and Vierge coming through turn 14. That really ran Vierge out to the curb.
Still not over, though, this battle for the lead. Joe Roberts cannot shake off the interest there from Aspar rider behind him, Aaron Canet.
Lovely shot there as they came over turn 11. Roberts and Canet crawling all over the front end of those bikes to just try and prevent the wheelie, get some drive.
We are on the last lap. One of these three guys is going to be very disappointed.
Just in a little bit hot. Canet was abusing that front tyre down the hill into turn five.
Roberts is lining up. Canet, there we go.
Yeah,
that was beautifully done.
Lovely.
And that's going to give Remy Gardner now a chance to get on top of things as well. He's now up towards Canet.
Going for the inside line. He's got the inside line up the inside of Joe Roberts. Brilliantly done.
Gardner's
got both of them, I think.
Roberts here, he's going to lose out, but he's now got the inside line back again. Remy Gardner comes to fight back. They're almost contact.
He touches
Joe Roberts wide. Roberts won't like that.
That was aggressive by Gardner. Laps ago, we thought it was Canet versus Roberts for the victory, and out of nowhere, Raul Fernandez has got a second win here. How much was he in tyre management mode? 43.008, as Steve mentioned, fastest lap of the race. He was 0.7 faster than Roberts on that last lap, almost half a second quicker than Canet.
He's come from 10th on the grid as well, Matt.
Well, we know he can do it in Moto3 in Portimao. It looks like he's showing as he can do it in Moto2 in Portimao as well.
It's Valencia versus Madrid here. Here comes number 25, Raul Fernandez, to take the lead of the Grand Prix with four to go. Great, great win for Raul Fernandez. He wins here in Portugal once more. What a rider, though, Aki Ayo has here.
But what a ride by this young man. What a performance by Raul Fernandez.
Incredible.
First time winner for him in the Moto2 World Championship. He's the 43rd winner in Moto2 since the category started.
Hey guys, it's Paul Espargaró. If you like the video, give it a like and subscribe to the channel.